The first speaker of this session is Sergei Khrushchev from Sadbaev University, and he will tell us about uniformly convergent Fourier series with universal power parts on closed subsets of measure zero. Sergei, please.
Okay, thank you to organizers to invite me to this very interesting conference. So I was invited a year ago and even planned to go to Sochi personally, but then COVID happened, so everybody knows this. And I just want to begin my talk to demonstrate the place where I am. So this is a panoramic view of Almaty. So this is south of the city. These are the famous Almaty mountains. And here the picture shows how it looks like from the side of mountains. So it is only 2 hours of walk from Mideo, which you can reach for 20 minutes. So in 2 hours, 20 minutes, you will be in this wonderful place and can think about mathematics. And there is another very beautiful place. You see Sasha here. So he visited Almaty in 2016 in September. And so we went him to Isik Lake, and it is a very beautiful lake, and it's a really wonderful nature here. So let me return back to the title of the talk, and I just tell you what I'm going to explain here. So we consider closed subsets of measure zero on the circle. Now, I just want to construct a continuous function on the circle with uniformly convergent Fourier series in the sense of symmetric Fourier sums, such that if I cut it to the restrict my attention only to the positive Fourier series, then the partial sums of this positive Fourier series will make a dense subset in the space of all continuous function on E. Clearly, this projection diverges and diverges in a very strong sense. So we are talking about investigation of how Carlson's theorem on the convergence of Fourier series in the space of square summable function is precise. So that is the main result announced on this slide. Now I just want to talk about the basic papers which lie the background of this proof. So first goes my paper of 2020, where I constructed just continuous functions with the same property. So it's Fourier series. I could not say that it converges uniformly. So the second is Carlson's famous paper in Acta Mathematica in 1966. And one of my favorite theorems in analysis. And it is important to stress that, Pfefferman provided another proof, but usually Carlson's proofs just give rise to new development. The typical example concerns Hardy algebra. So he just investigated interpolation problem, and he also solved corona problem. And in the solution of this problem, such measures which are called Carlson measures appear. So in this paper, there are very beautiful, it is usually he used the so-called the method of dyadic intervals, and the dyadic intervals theory reached the most development in this precise paper. So I would recommend everybody to read this original paper. It, by the way, contains some special polynomials associated with special dyadic intervals, and they control the partial sums of Fourier series. It's a very interesting paper. So I just cannot return to it. I just think it should be good to return to this paper and study it in more details. The second important paper is a paper of Vinogradov. So he actually extended Kolmogorov's theorem on the conjugate functions to the space, not measures, but the distributions, which are linear functional on the space of uniformly convergent series. So my approach actually, I just combined the method of this paper with these two papers, plus I also use important Oberlin's results on this matter. So the motivation for this topic was the following. So Bise and Murer, they wrote a very interesting paper in 2016 where they used my results on simultaneous approximation and just proved similar theorems of this type for different spaces of functions, but not for the type I'm talking about. So it is surprisingly interesting that in Comerson proved his theorem in 1966, and simultaneously Kahan and Katznesson, they proved an alternative. They could not prove losing conjecture, but they proved an alternative, which by the way explains why these results may be related to Carlson theorem. So for homogeneous, the definition of the homogeneous Banach space is given here. Well, it is quite natural. So the shifts are isometries. This function of the shift is continuous in the Banach space metric. And we call that a subset E of the unit circle, a set of divergence for Banach space B, if there is a function in this B whose Fourier series diverges at every point of E. For instance, for L1, Kolmogorov's examples give a function which diverges everywhere. So therefore, we just restrict our attention to functions in L1 and consider this function S star, which is supremum of partial sums. So a set E is called a set of divergence for a homogeneous Banach space, if and only if there is a function of this Banach space B such that S star is infinity for every point of E. So, and this is exactly the theorem of Kahn-Kesnerson, which says that B is a strongly homogeneous Banach space. So one more condition is imposed, such that it contains the space of continuous function. Then either T is a set of divergence for B, like in Kolmogorov example, or the sets of divergence for B are precisely the sets of measure zero. So that is actually an important result, shows that you have an alternative, either Banach space. For Banach space, you always can find a function for which Fourier series diverges everywhere, or the set of divergence are restricted to this to the sets of measure zero. So if you just look on this, then in the case, since we know that for L2 and as a consequence for the set of continuous functions, the set of zero Lebesgue measure closed sets are the set of divergence. So the question is how these divergence terribles, how you can measure it. And one of the measurement of divergence is just to require that any function on continuous function on E can be approximated by partial sums of function F in the uniform norm. So that is just the motivation for the whole paper. So to simplify the notation and the statement of the theorems, I give a definition. So given a closed set E, we denote by universal E the set of all function in L1 such that this set is dense in C at E in the uniform norm. So if such a function exists, then it is called universal for the set E. So I'm searching for universal functions for a given set of zero Lebesgue measure with the best possible properties. So It is interesting that you cannot, well, you, there is an interesting result obtained in this paper in 2019. So we denote by CA the disk algebra. Yes, so therefore, in this paper, they proved that if you consider K, the classical one-third counterset on the upper part of the unit circle, meaning that you just do this one-third process with the arc rather than with the interval, then this is called the classical one-third counterset on the unit circle. Then there are no function in disk algebra which is universal for this set. This is the first restriction. So we cannot make our function analytic and continuous to provide the universal property for any set. So here we have something which is different. And if you just reflect this K and consider the symmetric counterset on the whole circle, then there is no continuous function which is universal on the set K star. So therefore, if you restrict your attention only to continuous function, there is no way to prove that this function is universal. So there is a universal function for arbitrary set. It is not true, because counter examples given in this important paper show that it is not the case. Now, here is a theorem which is stated in my paper published in Journal of Approximation Theory in 2020. So I recall that VMOA is just the set of consists of U, it's the sums of type U plus V tilde, the tilde is the harmonic conjugation, so it is not CA. So it is proved that for such function, this set is non-empty. Equivalently, it is the same as I said, because of the representation of V more A in as a such a sum. So you can find a continuous function on T. And when you cut it, this will be just a function from V more A. And the partial sums of the power series will approximate any continuous function on E. So there, if it is not true for C octave, for VMO, it is true. So then this was proved. I start thinking, is it possible to improve? Of course, any smoothing condition cannot be imposed, because this violates everything, and then you go to the capacity or other things, which also can be considered. So the first idea was just to try to make this counterexample, as it is said in the title, to make this series uniformly convergent in the symmetric sense. So we denote by U the bounded space of all function which have uniformly convergent symmetric series with the natural norm. And the main theorem of this talk is that the intersection of U plus, meaning that you take risk projection with the universal function of E, is not empty. So therefore, this means that you can find a continuous function. The uniformly convergent series for this power series is universal for the set E. So I didn't mention Oberlin result in the introduction, because I need more details from Oberlin setting. So the idea of Oberlin was to prove interpolation theorem for uniformly convergent series. So he actually did the same which Vinogradov did, but in a different manner. So he just considered n star, just one point quantification of the set of natural numbers. And then if you embed this functions from uniformly convergent series to this set of the continuous function of this form, and it doesn't matter from which place you start because they uniformly approach to F. So therefore, it is embedding. So this will be an isometry of UFT into the Banach space of CK, and then you can consider the dual for this space will be the set of the of sequences of measures, and then you can write down the duality. The duality is written here. Is written here in this form, but when we thought about this with Vinogradov long before Oberlin, so Vinogradov's idea was to do the same, but we did not consider this part, so we did not. It was just a mistake, I think, not to do this. So if you take any linear functional on the space of uniformly convergent series, it is called absolutely continuous. Is for every epsilon bigger than zero, there is a trigonometric polynomial such that the norm in the dual space smaller than epsilon. So this functional in this case are called absolutely continuous. The advantage of UT is that the distribution which are functionals on U are well described as the sequences of measures. So then lemma says that that any functional on U can be represented. So there is a so-called Lebesgue decomposition as an absolutely continuous part plus the singular part of the mu infinity. Then important theorem is the theorem of Vinogradov, which, by the way, it looks like it is equivalent to Carlson's theorem, but it is not known, but it is essentially the same, but in one direction it is true. So from Carlson results, this result follows, and it follows because there is some Stein theorem which has a vector valued version, and it says that if this operator is bounded on L2, which is true in the case of L2 because Carlson theorem is proved, then there is a Kolmogorov inequality. This is exactly Vinogradov's third theorem. Carlson theorem already said, and now we use another result, which was, by the way, proved in Oberlin's paper. So it turns out that if you take this limit, then in this case, this limit is exactly the variation of mu s. Mu s is the singular part of mu on the unit circle. So in Oberlin's notation, this theorem says that if you have a bounded linear function on UT, then this limit, exactly this is the transform of the function, then the limit will be just exactly the same, just like this. Well, the main theorem is that if you have a functional such that it is like a generalization of Ries theorem, if you annihilate the powers of zeta, then or just zeta bar, then in this case, this absolute the measure is absolutely continuous. So the singular part is not present. So then after that, it goes a part which is borrowed from my paper of 2020, and it is exactly the same. And I use simultaneous approximation to construct function. So actually the simultaneous approximation is not constructive. So therefore I just proved that for any closed subset of E of measure zero, this pair satisfies this simultaneous approximation property. And then after that, we can prove this theorem. We can prove this theorem that that in any case, if this pair satisfies simultaneous approximation property, then we can approximate any continuous function on E. And the proof of the theorem, actually, you apply to the conjugate spaces and then apply all this technique which I talked about, and then the proof is finished. So I just deliberately left some space, just because here we have mathematicians who teach in the universities, and one of my favorite topics now was to develop teaching online. And it is not very well known. So here is my site. If you click here, and here, notice it is not I, it is Y. So it is on this site, I developed the system of teaching online from any place in the world with the better results than in offline teaching. So if you teach in the university, so you have to arrange the flow information directed to the students. This is quite simple. It can be done even with the Zoom. But if we are talking about the, it is not enough to teach this way. So there is the backward flow of information from students, and it must be controlled. And by the way, in 1982, I was in Purdue University, and just at this time, this university participated in, I think it is called ARPA program of Pentagon, when a number of universities, the number of them was 14, as far as I remember, they developed a network connection between all of them. And one reporter from the local newspaper took an interview of some IT professor from Purdue, and he asked him about what they were doing with this project. And the answer was very simple. He said that they just wanted to change the world. Those times, nobody believed this, except for me, because I really took this very seriously. And the result of their work we see now. Now just trust me that Microsoft did the same for education, for office work, and for other things. So the problem here is that what they developed in many fields, and there are no applications. For instance, for mathematics, I developed this, how to do this on this side. But for instance, for English teaching, for instance, for technical questions, they develop now some computer labs, which also they are included in this system. But if you tell this to your administrators of university, please tell them A1, which is free, does not work. You should buy A3, and it is very cheap, because one license for one professor means that you teach, they pay only for your phone with internet. It is just like pay for phone of all professors for a year. It is $39 per year. It is very cheap, cheaper than Zoom. But it is complicated. I must tell you, it is complicated. Still, if you are guided, then in this case can be easily done. So, and it is actually a wonderful system. I have never seen before anything like this. And I believe it was done by mathematicians, because it is a combinatorial system. So you should know something like 60 programs and understand how they are connected. In this case, everything will work fine. So therefore, for mathematicians, there's a big challenge. So that is my recommendation, just to turn attention. And by the way, for those who teach in two universities, like Andrei, they can go to Moscow, work with Sasha, and teach in both, no problem. So there is no difference. It is even better than offline teaching. So thank you for your attention. I finished.
Send the speaker. Any questions or comments, both on mathematical and educational part? Andrei, you have a question.
Well, thank you, Sergei. Thank you for this last advertisement. I will definitely take it seriously. Check your website. You skipped quite fast through the simultaneous approximation. Can you show again the definition? I just couldn't catch it.
I just found it. Maybe. So it is just you have a sequence of polynomials which approximate any continuous function on E, and at the same time in the norm of X, it approximate any function f in X. So that is two norm approximation by one functions, by one sequence of functions.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions or comments, please?
Is it possible to understand how you, for each particular set, construct this universal? So do I understand correctly? It's better to say that for any uniform convergent function is universal.
Sasha, it is actually very simple. So the key is this simultaneous approximation. So if you know that you can do this, yeah, using these polynomials, you can construct the series just mm-hmm. by hands if you have this sequence. But the problem is that you cannot prove this without considering the conjugate problem. And the conjugate problem goes to study the functionals on E and functional on X, and then this theorem of Kolmogorov plays an essential role.
I just would like to be more precise. How to get this subsequence for given function G?
But you, if you have F, you have polynomials, then you can approximate first, just for the first step, you approximate, you find something to F, approximate by epsilon, subtract, then shift this sequence so that you obtain the Fourier series, shift it to the right, and then again approximate by accuracy. Yeah. Then again, multiply, so just to move spectra to the right, yeah, and again
approximate. How is involved in this process?
What?
G function for which we construct.
But for G, we approximate. So we just take G, which is continuous function, and we just find a polynomial which goes to G as far as possible.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then after that, this polynomial is subtracted, and then a new function is approximated, but it is moved to the right. Mm-hmm. This approximation moves to the right, and it is possible because you have a simultaneous approximation property.
Yes.
So this part is constructive, mm-hmm. but to prove that you can have this property, it is not constructive. You cannot do this. That is the problem.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay, I suggest to thank the speaker again.